unfortunately not. The day after our open letter was published, the WHO reluctantly acknowledged that airborne transmission is possible. This is something which we knew for years. This is a respiratory infection and transmits like other respiratory infections. So what followed from the July open letter, in many countries, there have been some actions taken to control and do something about airborne transmission in, okay, in Germany, for example, but not in Australia.
Lydia, the leaks we've seen, the infection we saw in hotel quarantine, for a worker in Melbourne, is that almost certainly been transmitted through airborne transmission?
Well, if infections occur at a distance between people who have nothing to do with each other, there is very difficult to explain it in any other way. So, yes, I'd say there are airborne transmissions.
What does it mean for air travel?
Airplane is a different environment, and certainly there's a close proximity of people. There are different issues there. So masks during air travel is basically essential. Airline industry is taking a lot of effort right now to improve ventilation, improve the flow directions, and so on. But in hotel quarantines or in anywhere where people are infected, people are housed, ventilation has to be something which has to be very seriously considered and checked.
Right. So how do we fix this in hotel quarantine? Would it work if the air conditioning didn't operate and these hotel rooms, we made sure that anyone in hotel quarantine had an open door or a balcony?
This is a big oversimplification, air conditioner. This is not a problem with an air conditioner as a device. Every building mechanically ventilated has air heating and cooling air conditioning system, which is far more complicated just opening the windows. Of course, there's no time and place right now to go into that complexities. It doesn't mean that the mechanical ventilation system cannot protect people from being infected. It can, but those systems are not designed for these purposes and not necessarily checked whether there is no transmission of air between different locations, different rooms or shared space areas. Okay. So this is something which has to be reviewed.
All right. Well, hopefully that's discussed in National Cabinet today. Well, just finally, would you like to see these quarantine systems be in regional centres? Would that help some of the problems here?
Well, whether it's in regional places or wherever it is, the ventilation system in these places have to be seriously taken on board with the recognition that airborne transmission is the most significant mode of transmission. So starting from this, many things can be fixed, or if they cannot be fixed, then at least this will be acknowledged.